Okay, let's take a look at what we're doing in HDR in Photoshop CS5. I'm going to select 8 files, which is admittedly more than we'd normally use, but I want to show you just how much this feature can now do. It's now called HDR Pro. You see I'm driving it out of Mini Bridge here. I've downsampled the files for the sake of this demonstration. The idea with HDR is that high dynamic range photography, 32-bit image editing, and really the ability to get much more information out of several different images. So here, we've got a variety of different exposures. Now, when we redesigned HDR Pro, we wanted to give you a much better interface that allowed you to control things in a very intuitive way. So we have all new sliders. I've got new controls for edge glow radius, edge glow strength, new slider for gamma, new slider for detail, and an entirely new interface. As you can see at the base here, I've got all 8 of my exposures going from 2.5 stops overexposed to 2 stops underexposed. And while I can move these individually, I'm going to go ahead and load one of my presets. Photoshop CS5 ships with a number of these, and you can see that I can quickly get a nice punchy, vibrant image here. We'll allow you to go from wildly surrealistic to very photorealistic and everywhere in between, be that black and whites or very subtle changes. One of the things that you notice here is the barbed wire has a lot of artifacts. I'm going to choose to remove ghosts, and Photoshop's going to look through each and every image, and it's going to look at the areas that are moving in each of those. Now, this could be the grass on the ground, it could be the sky moving, it could be the tree. In this case, you can see it's immediately stabilized the barbed wire and locked onto the image highlighted in green below. You could choose to override that. Perhaps you have a person walking through an image and you'd like to explicitly use them or not use them in the image. So that gives you just an idea of some of what's going on there. Next thing that I want to show you is what we're doing with single image HDR. And the idea here is that we want to emulate HDR toning. We have a single image and maybe we want to mimic that aesthetic that we just saw in HDR. Or maybe we just want to do some things we weren't able to do to our images prior. Got some single image presets here. One of them is high contrast, black and white. You can see we have the same controls, but again, it's just with a single image. I can come in here and make that more of a crunchy, high contrast color image, or even a very soft image that looks almost like a painting. Just to show you a little bit of what we can do, we can reduce the vibrance, increase the saturation, or vice versa, and end up with an aesthetic that we couldn't have before. It's a tremendous amount of control here, whether it's for your multiple or individual images. Show you one last example, before and after. On the left here, you see the image as I captured it. On the right, as we pushed it through HDR toning, dramatically overexposing it and coming up with an entirely new look to our image. So whether it's multiple images for a professional or a single image for someone who didn't think ahead to take HDR photos, we're giving you a lot of new ways to realize this aesthetic in Photoshop CS5.